Hi everyone, and welcome to our little concert. This was recorded back in August. At the time, we weren't sure if it was a concert or a recording session, but we were very happy to have a small live audience present in one of our favourite Bay Area venues of late. This is a converted bank building in Vallejo. It's visually very spectacular and acoustically very satisfying to play in. We're going to start with a Bach cantata, unusual in that it's rather late, written towards the end of his life. It's also only a single movement that survived, so to make it into a more complete piece, I put a little organ solo in front of it, and you'll see me playing organ, actually this very instrument that I'm sitting in front of. This is unusual for me. I really love to be at the harpsichord, but playing the organ is also an interesting experience, and it makes for a really nice instrumental blend with the other instruments. There will be times when I'm sure you won't be sure whether I'm playing or whether the recorder is playing some of those lines.
Thank you.
We're going to continue now with a toccata by Froboder. Ordinarily I might play this on harpsichord, but it was a fun experience to play it on this organ. I'm the only person who's playing on electronics here. Everyone else is playing pure acoustic instruments, which are set up very much as they would have been at the time the music was written. However, the organ is sampled sound from an instrument from 1742, and I really like it. After I've played the Froboder Toccata, we're going to go straight into some funeral sentences by Buxtehude. Buxtehude lived in the generation before Johann Sebastian Bach and was greatly admired by Bach. The music was written partly for the funeral of Buxtehude's father at this time. The instrumentation in the score is quite unclear, so I don't feel bad about reworking it for the instruments that we have today.
Thank you.
Now, after two rather somber pieces, you're probably ready for some real-life drama. And so is the music of Caldara. And I won't surprise you to find that I'm moving to the harpsichord now, which I much prefer as a dramatic instrument of accompaniment. These cantatas by Caldara were just written on two lines, a vocal line and a bass line. Everything above the bass is made up. Roy sticks pretty closely to the bass line. Marion and I have the freedom to do whatever we like with it and add whatever harmonies seem to be right in the moment. The text itself, you may find that it doesn't make a whole lot of sense, especially if you're in a happy relationship. If you're in a relationship that's not so happy, perhaps it will make a little bit more sense to you.
Qualche mattina parti sin all'ultime dì del viver mio, scorgerai nel mio petto la fiamma stessa del mio primo affetto.
After Caldara, we took a break in the concert. We needed it, not because we really needed a break. We just needed to calm down a bit before moving to the music of Purcell. If Caldara and the Italians were overtly dramatic, then drama in English music at this time tended to be a little bit more subdued. The English didn't quite trust anything that came out of Italy, and eventually they got the idea, but it took them a little longer to get there. This group centres around Hear the Deities Approve, a wonderful aria from a longer composition in honour of Saint Cecilia. The bass line is very familiar to keyboard players. There are a lot of keyboard pieces from this time based on that or a very similar bass line, so I couldn't help sticking one of those in front of this as an introduction. The one I chose is actually by William Croft. If you listen closely, you might notice that the bass line is not identical, but it's very close, and we think the two pieces work nicely together. The whole Purcell group is actually a suite of four. I'm then going to play a piece that you might recognize as Lily Bolero, And finally, a completely different piece by Purcell, which rounds out this group nicely. Thank you. There's no better way that we could end this concert than with a little opera by Handel. And not a whole opera, just one aria. And this is from Julius Caesar, from when Handel was in his late 30s, at the height of his powers as an opera composer. Plots of these operas are always very involved. I've never managed to get the hang of any of them, despite having played quite a few. But what is important is to get into the drama. Fortunately, this one's from near the beginning of Julius Caesar. So far, the story is that Caesar has defeated Pompeo in Egypt. Pompeo's wife pleads with Caesar for leniency, and Caesar says, yeah, but I would like to have a conversation with Pompeo. I think we have stuff to discuss. Unfortunately, Ptolemaio, the zealot, has already removed Pompeo's head and delivered it to Caesar in a box. Caesar is furious at the lost opportunity, and that's the backdrop to this wonderful aria that's going to round out the concert. Prior to that, we have three movements from a trio sonata by Telemann. Same period, same key, it makes a nice combination. Telemann's music is always perfect for the instruments, particularly the recorder. He just seems to have a knack of putting the recorder in the right range for the music. We hope you've enjoyed this concert. We're not charging anything for viewing, listening, but if you would like to make a donation, they're always really gratefully appreciated. Any amount is fine. We've been doing this all the way through the pandemic, and it's served to just about keep us in business. And you'll see the link to how you can easily donate right below my face.
Tutto pronto.